ILTV Plus, your news from Israel and more 24/7. Start your free trial today. Subscribe at ILTV.tv and watch from any device.
Moving on, Israeli cyber defense forces recently fighting off a number of cyber attacks, including a ransomware strike that devastated Hadera's Hillel Yaffe Medical Center last week. In fact, the health ministry is still working to recover and restore Hillel Yaffe's systems. But experts are continuing to warn that this is just one battle in a war that's just beginning. Here to discuss, head of product vulnerability research with Checkpoint Software's Oded Vanunu. Oded, thanks so much for being with us. Now, how many attacks are we fighting off, you know, per day, week, or month?
Okay, so this is the numbers that we are talking about are big numbers, and we need to understand that currently we are not surprised with the situation at all. Just to give the numbers, we are talking for the health institute or the health industry, we are talking about 1,400 attacks per week, attempts per week. This is like the double figure comparing to the average of the world. And this is something that we are seeing for a very long time. So basically, we can say that Israeli industry in all sectors, from health to governments and to education, are under big cyber attacks. And then this is something that will continue to happen. And we need to think differently right now to understand that this is the volume and what we can do to become better.
So when you're saying that Israel is receiving, you know, double the average of the rest of the world, are these considered cyber terrorist attacks, or are they more focused on money, which is what people are saying that they think it was a Chinese group that was looking for monetary gain in the case of Hillel Yaffe Medical Center?
So we need to understand that there are two main profiles today that creating or making the cyberspace very aggressive. The first profile are governments, countries. Countries around the world, governments around the world in the last 10 years shift budgets from conventional warfare into cyber warfare. And that means that their daily objective is to penetrate into other countries' facilities to gain intelligence and to gain access to the day of order. This is one profile, and we are talking about big scales of attack. Second profile is the cybercrime. Cybercrime in the last 10 years also become very sophisticated organizations that are being fueled by the cryptocurrency, which means that they can cash out on every activity that they are doing, and they can cash out with millions of dollars around the world. So that makes the cybercrime organization that are more powerful or like powerful like nations. And in Israel, unfortunately, we are seeing these two profiles, and this is exactly what explained the big numbers and the aggressives that we see in the industry.
So what do you suggest the Israeli government do? Because I'm assuming that they know as well as you do just how great the threat is.
Yes. So the Israeli government, they are not sitting, because things are being done behind the scene and things are being done gradually. I mean that currently, as I see it, or as I pointing what is the main problem, first of all, we need to understand that health industry was not considered as a critical infrastructure. That means that they have less budget for cyber defense. So this should be changed. Second, let's look at the industry of Israel. Cyber attacks or cyber, it's a war. It's a warfare. This is what happens. And in warfare, you need soldiers. What we are seeing is that there is a big gap today with quality people that can go and work as a cyber defense in hospitals or in government places, because the big money is in the high-tech, in the richest companies, on the technology companies, and people prefer to go work there. And that means that we don't have the professionalism that we have on the big companies, on government companies. So what we need to do is to make a big effort to educate a lot of people for cyber defense, because this is a warfare, and to make sure that we put the right people in places that we all know that are weak on defense in general.
All right. Oded Vanunu, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you very much.